exciting presentation is by Miriam Oke. She's from biomedical engineering, and her talk is entitled Human Intestine on a Dish. Miriam, the floor is yours.
2 years ago, while I was assisting a pediatric surgeon in an operating room at UNC, I was overcome with emotion when we had no choice but to remove the entire large intestine of the seven-month-old that we were operating on. This child, not even 1 year old, had already gone through multiple surgeries and intestinal biopsies in an attempt to treat the symptoms of his complex gastrointestinal disease. It made me wonder, why don't we have better tools to study human intestinal diseases in vitro or outside the body? In my current lab, we are trying to do just that. Our lab has helped develop a protocol that allows us to grow human intestinal stem cells on a dish and keep them alive for months. We can do this by taking a small sample of intestinal tissue taken from a routine biopsy and then carefully processing that tissue to isolate stem cells from the sample. The amazing thing about these stem cells is that with the right environmental cues, they have the ability to become any type of cell in the intestine. We can then take these stem cells and reprogram them using genetic engineering techniques to make them easier to track in real time. Imagine that stem cells are like fireflies and that other kinds of cells are like other kinds of bugs. Until the fireflies light up, we can't really tell them apart from other bugs in the night sky. However, in our lab, we can reprogram the stem cells so that they glow a bright green color under the microscope, kind of like a firefly, which then enables us to distinguish them from other cell types on our human intestine on a dish. We have already demonstrated this successfully in our lab, and the next step is for us to further modify the cells so that they can change into different colors depending on what cell type they turn into. This way, we can culture and grow the cells on a platform with different compartments representing the human intestinal tract and the underlying bloodstream in the body. For example, in the upper compartment, which represents the digestive tract, we can add pill-based medicines and chemicals produced by gut bacteria, while in the lower compartment, we can add immune components and therapeutics like IV drugs. With these technologies, this enables us to simulate the human intestine outside the body, and like a firefly, will hopefully shed some light on the potential of the future of personalized medicine for gastrointestinal diseases. Thank you.